So I told them to take a hike.
I thought you'd like lecturing. You do plenty of it to me.
Yeah, but that's different. I hate public speaking. Unless I'm winning something.
Aren't you giving that tour tomorrow?
The ramblings of an old man hardly constitute a tour. Besides, it's my last chance to be important before I fade into obscurity.
You're being melodramatic. You'll live on in the archives.
I can't wait.
My star was not born under a rhyming tree.
Rhyming planet.
What?
I was not born under a rhyming planet, nor I cannot woo in festival terms. Much ado about nothing.
Much ado about nothing?
The play.
I know not of this well-titled play. Does it bespeak my current state of woe?
Are you in love? Yeah, it does. Do you mind if I have a look? Well, your verses are strong, but I think the paint imagery is a bit much.
It was my state until quite recently.
Say, a bit of variety would be good.
Still, I think there is some merit in this one. My maid is as fair as a fresh-painted rose, and sweet as a luminous crest. Her love shall be true as a portrait's repose, until we are both laid to rest.
That's really depressing.
No, it is profound. How can love be spoken of without a little bit of sorrow?
I'm just saying you've written a bad poem, you're trying to call it profound. It's the oldest trick in the book.
Well, I should like to see you do better.
She floats on wings of silken grace, her beauty plain to all who see. Her charm has pierced my love-lorn face. Please float down, my Emily.
Tis adequate. The final rhyme is strained.
Yeah, well, she thought it was pretty good.
I'm sure it is good enough for thy common wench, but my Rachel is not among that number. Perhaps this new spun verse will do the trick. My Rachel is sweet, my Rachel is fair. Am I fair enough for her? My verse is so stiff that my song's all despair, but still I'm in love with her.
That was actually better. Let's give this a go.
I'm Jerome, by the way.
Reginald.
Dreams grow rife, and to hell with what people think.